Mr. Marriott was not suspended. I was entitled to express my views. I was entitled to be consulted.
Did you threaten to overrule
him? I was not entitled to instruct Derek Lewis, and I did not instruct him. And
did you threaten to overrule him?
The truth of the matter is that Mr. Marriott was not suspended. I did not overrule Derek Lewis.
Did you threaten to overrule him?
I took advice on what I could or could not do.
Did you threaten to overrule him, Mr. Howard?
I acted scrupulously in accordance with that advice. I did not overrule Derek Lewis.
Did you threaten to overrule him?
Mr. Marriott was not suspended.
Did you threaten to overrule him?
I have accounted for my decision to dismiss Derek Lewis.
Did you threaten to overrule him?
Detail before the House of Commons.
I note you're not answering the question whether you threatened to overrule him.
The important aspect of this, which it's very clear to bear in mind.
I'm sorry, I'm going to be frightfully rude, but.
Yes, you can.
I'm sorry. It's a quick, straight yes or no
question, and I will give you an answer.
Did you threaten to overrule him?
I discussed this matter with Derek Lewis. I gave him the benefit of my opinion. I gave him the benefit of my opinion in strong language. But I did not instruct him because I was not entitled to instruct him. I was entitled to express my opinion, and that is what I did.
With respect, that is not answering the question of whether you threatened to overrule him.
It's dealing with the relevant point, which is what I was entitled to do and what I was not entitled to do. And I have dealt with this in detail before the House of Commons and before the Select Committee.
But with respect, you haven't answered the question whether you threatened to overrule him.
Well, you see, the question is, what was I entitled to do and what was I not entitled to do? I was not entitled to instruct him, and I did not do that.